Yep, so if that's all, can the lights in front maybe can just dim the lights in front? Cannot. If cannot, then that's fine. Okay, so personally, VR for myself is I'm also quite new to it. In fact, I'm just doing this as more of a hobby kind of thing. But since they have asked for speakers, so I'm here to just share what I've found so far. So feel free to point out if, let's say, you have better ways of doing certain things along the way. Okay, so the good news is nowadays creating content for VR is easier, especially with software like Unity that make 3D game development a lot more easier. And in fact, just this last week only, Unity just released a whole new set of samples for creating content on VR. So they actually came up with like some standardization on how to do all this. So if you are new to VR creation, you can actually choose Unity and also just check on their website for the tutorials. So this is like, okay. Hello. Hello, testing. Can hear? Okay. Yeah, so you can see the UI, the samples that is provided includes how do you do a UI in VR, FPS, first-person shooter. You can do like navigating a maze using VR. You can fly a plane in VR as well. So these are like more or less the main types of interactions that you may expect to have in a VR game. So this is now available, whereas previously people have to come up with their own ideas in terms of controls. And as you all know, VR is very new, so controls in VR is even newer and quite fragmented. Some guys have tried to come up with their own ways of doing such controls, but it has never been standardized. So with this, even Unity have come about to like standardize, like, okay, how can you use gaze control, like staring at a button and then doing this. They came up with some recommendations and best practices that the industry can follow. So with this, I won't be going through this particular demo since Unity itself has a lot of videos and guides for these samples on how to use that. So probably going through those will be better for you guys instead of the 15 minutes that I have here. Okay. However, I'll just show like how you can, given an existing 3D project, easily just do VR. So what I'm going to be using is I'll be using a Google Cardboard SDK because it's actually easier to pick up compared to the Oculus, which these samples here are based off on. Yeah. So the example, okay, the lighting here is quite bad, but basically what I'll be using here is this isometric third-person shooter game example, also free from Unity. So the game itself, the game here is actually, when it's provided from Unity, is a tutorial on how to create your own isometric third-person shooter game. So just based off this example, I managed to just use the Google Cardboard SDK to convert this third-person shooter into a VR survival shooter. So I'll just run through quickly like how I managed to do that. So okay. Most of you would have like checked out like Google Cardboard website. So just by going there, you can easily download SDK for Unity. And then once you downloaded the SDK, I just imported it into this project. And from there, I actually get this prefab, which is in Unity what is called like, basically in construction, you pre-build certain things. So this prefab is already done by Google for us. We can easily just drag and drop. So what I did was I just drag and drop this over here. And the moment it appears on the scene in this game example. Okay, wait a minute. So let me just put down the mic first. So with this step, I can easily, all this without additional coding or anything, is instantly done for me by the example code that was provided by the Google SDK. So the first thing that we can see here is, so I'll just pause this. Just okay. So what is provided from the cardboard SDK is this thing called the head object, which contains a camera for the left camera and the right camera. So this comes pre-built for use directly by Google. And what I've done here is, you basically move this thing onto your 3D character. So in this case here, our 3D character here is this character that will be in the middle of the game when the game loads. So what I'll do is I'll drag this onto the character as a child of the character. So once your character moves around, the camera object, which is now a child of the character, will also move with the character. And head tracking itself is already inbuilt. You do not have to do anything. And when you're testing on your laptop or desktop, you can just hold down the alternate key and you can use your mouse to simulate accelerometer, gyroscope movement on your mobile device in this case. Yeah. So this is just a very quick example of how you can easily do this to, let's say you have your existing game and stuff like that. So for people who are new to VR, this is actually a good, if you have some existing game, you can do that. But obviously, if you read on like Oculus, their blog and stuff like that, they always recommend that just porting an existing game into VR is always not good because it's not built for VR. But then again, just for hobbyists to have somewhere to start, I think this is a good practice. And from there, you can see how things goes. So like some of the issues I will have I've encountered is, your camera may have collision with the characters and stuff like that. So you have to play around with the collider to make sure when the character moves, the cameras, if it knocks against someone, the camera doesn't get goes off. And in fact, I uploaded this onto the Play Store. I did this in like maybe like 1 to 2 hours. I uploaded to the Play Store. I got like a few thousand downloads and some feedback from the players. So like the default, let me just show you the game, how it looks. Yeah, so you can see here, there is some gameplay element because for VR, obviously you you can use your head to look at the enemy. So what I've done here is with the head tracking, the moment the player looks at the enemy, I will auto fire the gun. So this is like one way to make use of the head tracking as an input. So some commands were, now that the flash light of the muzzle is directly in your face, players actually complain that it's blinding them when they are playing this game. So I have to edit and like tone down the thing because originally this was a third-person shooter, so the flash doesn't really affect you when you're firing the gun. So then there are all these things to take note of. And when you're doing VR, you can't really control. So what I did was I added a Bluetooth support. So you can use, if you hook up Bluetooth to your phone, you can actually control the movement of the character. But then again, I also realized that not everyone will have a Bluetooth controller. So I actually have an easier mode for them where the spawn rate of the enemies are a lot more reduced. So you can technically just stand still and just turn around to shoot at them and you can survive for a while. Yeah. Whereas the default mode, there will be so many that you just can't survive if you don't move around to avoid them. Yeah. So sometimes when you change your game for VR, you still have to do some tweaks here and there. So even the shooting, I had to change a bit of the code to do recast based on the gaze as well. Yeah. So I think that's it. Just a quick demo. There are also some other examples. So this was this is another example that you can follow from Unity, one of their conference. I think it was just this year. So they actually had, during their conference, they have a lot of hands-on labs. So one of the examples here is, they actually work with Google. I think this was either Google or Unity. So they will show you like how step-by-step, how you can do something with it, everything with Unity, and then, yeah, so, so this is just the game here, yeah. So, yeah. Any questions, I guess?
We have gameplay video?
Huh? Gameplay video? I can pass around the device later if anyone of you is interested. I mean, it's just a simple shooter game, yeah.
I think later we can do it. Yeah. Demo after the event.
I mean, I have a couple of samples. I also did an example where I hooked up like a flight sim kind, so you can control a plane using the controller as well. So, but nothing big. All so far that I've been doing are more like small experiments. Yeah.
Do you use any asset for the game?
Okay. This particular example here. This one is a free asset from Unity itself.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so it comes with music, sound effect, 3D models, even the AI for the enemies are all there. So I just tweak their rate to be less and stuff like that.
It's a free,
it's a free asset. It's just called. Yeah, so I think it's just survival. Are they over here? So yep. Okay. So some of the reviews that I got is graphics very good, but then I didn't do the graphics.
Yeah, but I think that you can find this game on the App Store.
Yeah. I mean,
by Jibon Sherman Company.
Yeah. A lot of people have used the same asset as well. Yeah.
Just now I was about to ask you how much is it.
Yeah. So basically, it's free. Yeah. And they have versions for, but just take note, they have versions for different versions of Unity. So like version 5, they have a separate asset that you should download separately. Yeah. Okay.
In terms of image quality, which render engine is the best for photorealistic images?
Okay. Right now, I would guess, for me at least, is for VR, is just mainly competition between Unreal and Unity. Personally, the main difference I see between the two of them is Unity, by default, out of the box, it will try to gear more for performance. Whereas Unreal, by out of the box, it will be more towards the quality, the look. So depending on what you are trying to achieve, if let's say you want your game to support as many devices as possible with least issue, you may want to go with Unity. But let's say you're more concerned with like just a few high-end devices with high quality, and you don't want to really tweak the stuff, then maybe you can use Unreal. Yeah. So that's that. Yeah. But okay, one thing here you can see is this example is not meant for mobile. So when I ported it for the cardboard, which is for Android devices, I actually had to do a lot of optimization. So basically what I did was I just selected all the shaders, changed all of them to mobile shaders. All the textures from like maybe 2048, I changed them all to 512. Then yeah, it partially reduces the size of my APK, and hence the memory needed also less. Otherwise, when I first tried it on the phone, it was very laggy. Yeah. Because this is actually an example to show all the nice shaders and blooms and stuff like that. So that is not so good for the mobile device. But I guess if you do test on Oculus desktop, then maybe this is still fine. Yeah.
Are you saying that there are standardized controls in the VR samples given by the Unity technology?
Correct.
Can you tell more about it? Like what's
okay.
These controls are like?
Yeah. Yeah. So this part over here, so this is an example. So like let's say you're new to it, you don't know all the terms about like UI input controls in VR. Now Unity has come about, set up all this tutorial. They give you all this very complex name, and now you have a name for all these kind of controls, the inputs, the interface. So like then they explain to you what all these are now. Compared to previously, some guy would just, I call it a gaze control, but
yeah.
Is there a proper name for it? You don't know. Yeah. And they will like say, like in this case here, they actually have like the interaction portion as well. So like you can sometimes fill out a bar instead of a circular field. Then they even have this example of you navigating through a maze in VR. So in this case here, you can actually look at an object rather than a UI or stuff like that as well, kind of stuff. Because I think actually end of the day, even with this, you can see from the end users, right? People still, if possible, they don't like gaze control. Yeah, so that part, unfortunately, Unity is not a hardware manufacturer. They can't help to standardize on the end. So that one right now is still fragmented. So Oculus will be using their own wrist control. Then some other guys is using, I think, leap motion and stuff like that. That one is still still going to be fragmented for now.
But these controls are based on the user interfaces, right?
Correct. These are all software-based sort of controls. Yeah. Which on for certain kind of games, it is still sort of not so good. So let's say you are in a action game where reaction time is very fast and you need to move around very fast. Every time you need to make a turn, you have to stare at the button for 3 seconds, then you turn. So that is still not so good right now for these kind of games. Yeah.
These are different from the third-person controller and first-person controller with the Unity by default. Like the VR controllers are different than the standard one, right? Or they're the same?
For this case?
Yeah.
Okay, this case here, most cases here, they are using sort of like more first-person, except maybe for the ship one, is sort of a bit more. But end of the day, it is same because you are using your gaze. Yeah. So the object, whether is it third person or first person, is actually just the 3D object, whether is it behind you or in front. So that part is actually still the same. And actually, I think, was it 16? If you guys are more like interested on the console VR side, there's also this Sony, they are coming down to have more for the game developers. They'll be bringing down the Sony VR as well. Is
16th of December.
Yeah, 16th yes. December here. Yeah, is it on this block as well? Yeah.
Okay. All right. Thank you.
Okay.
Yeah.